Hello guys, my name is Fox and welcome to part 33 of our Crusader Kings 2 Horse Lore series. Let's continue. So, in the previous episode we have started our series of raids against Byzantine Empire because, as already said, I want to get rid of their army if possible before declaring war on them. Just so we could ensure that we could win, because as soon as they are gonna declare on them, as we already know, they're probably gonna get benefits from like fighting against foreigners, fighting against infidels, and it's gonna increase the amount of troops he could raise from the vassals, and it's gonna be pain in the butt. So I would want to prevent such things just by destroying his army. So also we could pillage some more stuff in our realm, which I'm gonna do right now, because we're spending tons of money on all the replenishment of troops. Because their army is actually still bigger than ours. And yeah, we couldn't really participate in direct combat with them, unfortunately. Also, we're getting pillaged by 180 people. And that's really annoying, because I can't really do much. Because all of my troops are actually right now in here. Actually, if you're gonna burn down these things, it's fine. I'm not really getting any income from them anyways. Also, you guys need to be probably get combined again. Population of Mancia got converted to our fate. Awesome. And you actually do not need to lead combat. Probably just gonna be continue researching cultural tech in here. And yeah, they have 15,000 troops in there, and unfortunately, I have less than that. At least while they're not replenished. Yeah, we only have 13,000. We have a daughter from our brother. Great. And we need a new marshal. Oh, this guy is actually a siege leader, so I don't want him to be not leading the combat. Also, nephew. We need to... No, not a marriage. Just need an educator. Go get educated. And new commander. Flanker, who are you? My nephew. Awesome. Where are this guy going? Has anyone yet declared war on him? No. Someone is still pillaging him on this coast. While he's not coming for me, I'm gonna continue pillaging Alesha, I guess. We got a daughter. Awesome. I definitely prefer to have more sons, because this one is not particularly great. And we already get tons of concubines, so it should happen at some point. And yeah, we're spending tons of money. Actually, why are we spending so much money on reinforcements if you're not even having any manpower? Is it reasonable at all? Maybe I should like keep it on the half speed. Okay, now you're gonna come back for me. How about this place? Why are you prioritizing me instead of him? Okay, I guess I'm gonna retreat. Opinion changes or the just trade. Okay, I'm just, I guess I'm gonna throw you in the dungeon. It would be great if Basilius would decide to split his army and let me deal with him. Let me destroy half army first and half the other time. For instance, that I was just and gave the thief a suitable punishment. Awesome. Some opinion with him. And we got a new son. Nice, sweet. We could usurp something. High chiefdom of Kola. No. Also, how's our opinions looking? Because last time we actually got a rebellion. So now we need to improve relations with people a little bit more. We're already improving with Akun. Oh, and apparently they are fighting dispute against Uyghur. Okay, it's interesting. I don't know what dispute was, because actually as a Khagan, I could not declare a dispute wars. That's interesting. Yeah, manpower is definitely been a problem. Monthly manpower growth plus 31. That's why we could not freaking replenish our army anytime. But actually, if they only have 15,000, I have 13, and my vassals could raise like 20,000. Oh yeah, but they are now attacking Khazaria again. Probably gonna lose. I already lost the war against Khazaria not that much time ago. Also Uyghur or Akhun. Why do you have such a small army? You're supposed to have a lot more than that. Someone else is pillaging him. And yeah, as I said, I want to raise mercenaries. The only problem with the mercenaries would be that they're gonna spawn in here and I would need to move them through the rest of the country before they're gonna be able to engage, and I would have to pay tons of money for this. Monthly costs 37 ducats, are you sure? It's actually a stupendous number. 37 ducats per month for 360 troops. Okay, probably not gonna be able to afford it actually, now that I think about it. Could become paranoid or trusting. I think paranoid gonna be better, but it's not happening. How's the war with Khazaria? You're at war for Bashkiria. Bashkiria is in here. Okay. And how's your dispute? The Uyghur actually winning. Actually, you're not Uyghur. You are... Oh, you are Uyghur clan. Okay. Count Butcher of Uyghur has usurped the title Count of Uyghur from some dude. Hey, you're not supposed to be expanding this way. But oh well, if you actually want to declare wars on each other, it's not gonna matter for me much, because their lands, this land's still gonna stay in my realm. Just underneath other... underneath another one clan. Okay, what the hell am I gonna do with this replenishment? Because it's not... 30 troops per month is just like nothing. And even if I'm gonna spend more money on this, it's not gonna matter. What's this actually gonna do? This means you will pay full reinforcement cost, 10% of rest, and you will reinforce per month. 5% zero, but yeah. With such low manpower, I couldn't reinforce even 5% per month, so... no real reason to spend so much. Also, I need to switch off. I think, I guess... At least I could take some more money from him. And yeah, I would need to probably wait on my vassals to finish all their other wars before declaring the war for Byzantium. Because they are gonna be distracted if I were to call them in right now. Let's go for Galas. Oh, it's actually replenished already, so we could burn it down again. Let's go and sit in here for some time. Let's see if he's gonna attract any armies in here. Maybe only half of them. Also, I saw that he have some higher troops. 3,000 higher troops, and he have no gold. And I assume hired is mercenaries, so... if he were to... oh! Here we go! Defending against Abbasid's holy war for Edessa. That's actually gonna be a perfect time. Abbasid's definitely gonna take his attention. And as we already see, the amount of troops he have raised tremendously. To 29 from vassals, because they're defending against infidels, foreigners, and all this bullshit. But I think I would be ready to declare a war on him right now. Or actually, I could wait for Abbasids to destroy some of his armies. Because Abbasids have a little bit more than the Basileus. Also, actually, the troops from this vassal could be destroyed right now. Why not? Let me see if I could catch any small armies. It would be really useful. Also, suffering attrition here is not something I want to do. Why the hell the supply limit in here is so garbage. We're not supposed to be like different tech or different religion, so what's the problem? No, at least we caught 1,000 troops in here. That's actually great. Some more there. I hope we're not gonna be fighting with these neutral troops. Please. Let me catch you. God damn it. Stay here. Oh, of course we're fighting with 2,000. Even though Croatia is neutral to me. But it doesn't matter. Actually, I'm a pillager, so maybe it affects this somehow, but it's still quite annoying. Something just happened. I need to call in my troops in here also. This guy trying to overthrow me. That's not great. Okay, we destroyed this army. Let's go and destroy one more small second here. We're down to 27,000. Yeah, let's go and destroy as much small stacks as we can. Because it's definitely gonna help. Only problem is that they are running like crazy. Do we have an organizer in here still? We do. Oh, more raven mobs. How great is that? Let's go and call in our vassals. Maybe they're gonna do something with them. Come on, stop running. Okay, you are dead. You're the next. And how much do you have now? 13k. Oh! Looks like there's some kind of huge battle happened between you and Abbasids. Okay, yes, it's definitely the time for me to declare on you. I know my people gonna be... gonna be... like, get their attention on this stupid rebellion. But it's gonna finish pretty soon, so you're not gonna be looters anymore, and we're gonna declare a war on Byzantine. And we would actually try to, not subordinate, where is this? Subjugation of Byzantine Empire. Yay! Let's call in all of our vassals. And I hope you're not gonna be trying to rebel while, you're in at war, or while you're in war with me together, because it would be pretty stupid. Oh, you go here. You improve relations. And Mujd. Actually have pretty decent relations with you, so why do you have to be such a jerk and try to overthrow me? I don't know. Also, apparently we have 2,000 freaking pillagers there. That's not acceptable. Also, we need to get our leaders in charge. Well, let's get you. You're on the flank. Actually, we need a siege leader in the middle. And this guy on the flank. Gonna be better. I need to start sieging the basilis. So. Oh, you only have now 7,000 troops. Great. Also, let's go and try to siege something that is actually siegeable and not tribal holdings. Okay, you go for Galas. We have our siege leader in here. It's gonna be relatively quickly. Also could get an ambition, apparently. Mass wealth, sounds great. We have 70% of my power. Actually would, or you could decide to rebel against me. Actually don't know if we could, while we are allies at war. Not entirely sure. Also, we could pillage some more. That's gonna be useful right now, because my expenses is still pretty freaking high. So, Abbasids declared a war, whole war for Edessa. And Edessa is not really that huge. And the rest is gonna be taken by me, because I think subjugation should actually just take the rest of the realm. So, if it's gonna happen, I would be so happy. Also, could this stupid heretics please stop spawning more troops? It's really annoying. Also, you just improved relations with Akun. Let's go and send you to Mujde, because they are now rebellious. So I'd really like them to not do this. Okay, some sieges happening. 4% for this. Actually, if you're getting 4% for this one little province, it's not gonna be a problem to even finish this war. Oh, nice. I just immediately improved relations with him. And there's no factions anymore. But I couldn't get you to another one job. You won't have some courtier and you. Yeah, why not? Also, I think we could get the speed down a little bit. And got 50 gold from here. Okay, there's the first siege. Let's go for the others. And our vassals starting to get here. 10,000 from you. Yeah, we're definitely gonna have a bigger army right now. 8,000. You only have 8,000. Thanks to the Abbasids. And thanks to my pillages as well. I definitely managed to kill at least like 7 or 10,000 of the Byzantines before attacking. And it probably helped. God damn it. How freaking much reinforcements are you gonna receive, you stupid rebellion? Lost our steward. Could get a new one. And you're gonna be researching an economy tech, because I can't really afford to build anything right now. So I'm not gonna do it. Not gonna do this. Family first. Oh, I have a family focus? Yes, I do. Okay. Actually, let's go to speed 4. The siege is gonna be finishing a lot quicker this way. So, if I were to enforce demands. Subjugates Basileus of the Byzantine Empire. Yes, it definitely gonna give me all the rest of the Byzantine Empire. Oh my god, that's gonna be so glorious. It's gonna be so glorious. I'm gonna become Basileus myself. And it's gonna be fun. Actually, if I'm gonna settle in Constantinople, it's probably gonna destroy the rest of this thing. It's probably gonna get shattered or something like this. But we'll see. It doesn't matter. Okay, there goes the rebellion. Thanks God, and thanks my vassals for helping in that. Get some more money out of here. 400 ducats. Maybe you could even spend something on construction. I don't know. Not now. Also, Mujde, why are you not in war anymore? Probably should call you in again. Right? Yeah, you are not. You're not in the war. Let's go and click this button again. That's strange. Why can't I call you? Actually, you're still sieging this thing, but you're not technically my ally in here. I don't know. That's weird. Okay, finish this siege. Let's go with, like, Severin. Oh, and even destroy some armies in the way, if possible. Great. Some free war score. How's your war with Abbasids? It's still going. And how's your army counts? You only have 5,000 and you became stressed. Yeah, I would definitely become stressed if the rest of my empire would be in danger of getting subjugated by some random dude. Okay, is this siege gonna count for our war? Yes, it actually does count, even though they are not technically my allies for some reason. More pillagers. And more pillages. Yeah, we actually have 500 ducats. We definitely need to start spending them. Like on something. Yeah, let's actually get some more clan sentiment. Considering that we already received a couple of rebellions, I would prefer it not to happen in the future. And we fulfilled the Amath Wealth ambition. Should give us one stewardship. I don't know how much we had previous time. And Mush the guy is actually running away now. Yeah, it's definitely not calling him in for some reason. Oh, I guess managed to raise 3,000 troops. Definitely need to kill them. It's gonna be a pretty nice bump in the war score. No, never mind. Actually, the battles with the vassals looks like doesn't count for some stupid reason. And by sieging only this little piece, we already have 61% war score. That's just insane. It should not be like this. Oh, but the battle with the Basilius himself definitely gonna count. Let's try to catch him if possible. Yes, it is possible. And 6% more, great. Let's go and siege Nicopolis now. And actually, it is already a time for me to have break, guys. Oh, we're delivering some more troops in here. Well, let's go and destroy them, and then we're gonna have to take a break. And looks like the war with the Basilius... Oh, never mind, this guy's gonna do it for me. The war with Basilius we would have to end in the next episode. And maybe the next episode even gonna be the last one, if I'm gonna be able to settle, or... Maybe I could continue after settling this. We'll see. We'll see how it's gonna actually work out and what's gonna happen with our empire, because I think that other clans is actually not gonna be controlled by us if we were to become a feudal or merchant republic or whatever I would want to choose. But yeah, we'll see. So, if you enjoyed watching this, you could leave a like. If you want to see more, subscribe. And if you want to leave a comment, you should definitely do it. And I would answer you as soon as I could. See you later, guys. Bye-bye.